Filipino fishermen asked President Marcos to protect them from Chinese harassment in the West Philippine Sea. They made the appeal as a record number of Chinese ships is detected in disputed waters. Michael Deliso reports.
In this video, personnel of China Coast Guard boarded a rubber boat to drive away a Filipino fishing boat near Bajo de Masinloc. Fisherman Francis Alaras confronted the CCG.
This is my Philippine territory! This is my Philippine territory! This is my exclusive economic zone of the Philippines!
But he was also forced to retreat when a bright light was aimed at him. In another video, Francis's boat was already about 30 nautical miles away from Bajo de Masinloc, but a CCG vessel still chased him away.
One last stick to mga kakapali ng pagmumuka nito, guys.
This is the common experience of Francis and his fellow fishermen during their voyages to fish in the West Philippine Sea.
Kawawa kamo kami ng mga inisto. Wala na kami mahuli.
Presidente, pakinggan mo na yung mga taing namin.
Kaya na umabot po tayo.
Hindi, wala po kaming magawa dahil mga bakal po sila. Kahoy lang po kami.
Francis was among over 100 fishermen from several towns in Zambales province who attended a dialogue with government officials on Tuesday. In the forum, the fishermen emphasized their desire to approach the reef for a more bountiful catch. It is also important for them to enter the lagoon, especially during bad weather, but this has been blocked by China. The Philippine Coast Guard and the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources said they are strengthening their patrols to assist the fishermen in times of need.
That's a sad truth nangyayari sa Bajo de Masinloc. It is an open book now. We have very limited number of assets. So it's not 24/7 that the Coast Guard will be there. But we are always strategically deploying our vessels.
Pag na po natin ikompromiso ang ating kaligtasan, then alam naman natin na wala tayong mapagkukublian, sundin po natin ang ambisyo ng Coast Guard na kapag masama ang panahon, huwag po tayo lumayag.
One fisherman asked how the government will address China's aggression and supposed attacks. Security officials said the government will continue to pursue a peaceful resolution to the issue despite the capacity to use missiles.
Kung gustuhin natin, pwede tayong lumesa baka. Pero ayaw po natin gawin yon. Ang gusto po natin ay diplomatikong solusyon. Ayaw po natin ng gera.
Meanwhile, the Philippine Navy spotted 251 Chinese vessels in the West Philippine Sea over the past 7 days, a new record high this year. These include China Coast Guard, People's Liberation Army Navy, Chinese Maritime Militia, and research and survey vessels.
Ito ang pinakamalaking increase. From 157, it went down a bit, then it went up to 251. For whatever reason, I don't want to speculate on that. We continue monitoring, we continue performing our mandate.
Since Monday, Chinese research and survey vessel along with 6 maritime militia ships have been loitering near Palawan's coastline. The BCG has already deployed the BRP Cape Engaño to shadow the supposed research mission.
The Philippine Coast Guard vessel has been deployed to carry out itong patrol natin na to para ma-prevent yung mga ganitong uncoordinated and no permission from the Department of Foreign Affairs to conduct MSR Chinese government.
3 Navy ships were also sent to check on the reported presence of the research vessel, but the vessel was not there anymore. Despite the challenges, the government continues to encourage fishermen to go out to sea and assert their rights in the waters. Michael Deliso, ABS-CBN News.
A security analyst calls for a consistent stance on the Philippines' position in the West Philippine Sea dispute at the upcoming ASEAN summit in Laos. Regional leaders are set to convene in the southeastern country to discuss key issues. Dr. Chester Cabalsa says President Marcos needs to assert the Philippines' position on the maritime conflict.
Consistency of our narratives and upholding the rules-based norms are key indicators on how we would position our priorities in the ASEAN. I remember that we, in the ASEAN way, where we uphold the principles of non-interference and the decision-making is consensus, not only Lao that has the higher voice there. We should remember that since this is a consensual summit, by the member states, we are expecting that there would be a prominent decision coming from all the member states.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. certifies the proposed 6.35 trillion peso 2025 national budget bill as urgent. Now, this would allow the House of Representatives to pass the general appropriations bill on second and third reading on the same day. Marcos says certifying the measure as urgent will ensure uninterrupted operation of critical government functions. House leaders are targeting to pass a budget today, September 25th. House Speaker Martin Romualdez doubled down on this following their LEDAC meeting with the president.
Mamayang gabi po, maipapasa natin po yan on third and final reading and ready for transmission in short order to the Senate. Kaya itong pinaka-importanting batas na hinaharap natin po sa Kongreso at tapos yung kumpiyansa ko na ito ay maitatapos natin itong gabi dahil sa pagka-certify ng Malacanang urgent po itong batas na ito po. Kaya that will be done.
Inaantabayan na namin ang pagbigay sa amin ng approved version o tinatawag nating GAP o General Appropriations Bill galing sa Kamara upang magsimula na ang talakayan tagkaugnay ng 2025 budget sa plenaryo ng Senado. Sa ngayon, on schedule ang mga pagdinig sa komite ng Senado at inaasahan namin na ito'y maaprubahan ng may sapat na panahon para ito'y mabasa at ma-review ng Pangulo kaugnay ng mga line item veto na maaari niyang gawin sa panukalang budget upang maging ganap na batas ito bago matapos ang taon.
The lower house giving one last chance to Vice President Duterte to defend her office's proposed 2025 budget in the plenary. This following another no-show from Duterte Tuesday. Her office's budget sponsor, Representative Zia Alonto Adiong, assured the public the Vice President's refusal to attend the House budget debates will not delay the passage of the 2025 national budget. Adiong believes the OVP's budget will not see further cuts. The House Appropriations Committee earlier slashed the agency's proposed 2 billion peso budget to over 700 million pesos.
I anticipate that there won't be any further amendments and further realignment of some of the line agencies because the proposal and or the recommendation of the Committee on Appropriations are funds that are enlarged and identified to be the operation of the Office of the Vice President for its operation. Mainly these are funds allotted to the PS, the Personal Services, and also for MOOEs. So any reduction, personally, I would say, any reduction from that proposed recommended amount would not render positively on how the Office of the Vice President would operate itself.
Adiong also defends his colleagues' frustrations over the Vice President's attitude, but he asserts this does not mean they want Duterte impeached.
Those are signs of frustration, disappointments from my colleagues, which I completely understand. Each agency really has to be present during, especially during budget plenary debate, because that is a requirement, that is a process that is required of each of us, required of each agency. This is the first time, in the history of our nation since the post-EDS that a sitting vice president refuses to attend the budget deliberation. But I understand the exasperation of some of my colleagues. I respect their position.
There is no word yet if Duterte will show up in the lower chamber's last plenary deliberation today, but she confirmed she will not attend another House hearing into the budget utilization of the Education Department, which she used to head. A clash at the Senate over the voting rights of residents of 10 former Makati villages that are now under the jurisdiction of Taguig City. Senators Mig Zubiri and Alan Peter Cayetano make that engaged in a shouting match. over the Senate's adoption of a resolution seeking to include the 10 villages in the two legislative districts of Taguig City and the municipality of Pateros, and confirming the increase of the number of councillors in each district of Taguig. Zubiri questioned the tackling of the resolution, which was authored by Cayetano, saying this was not part of the Senate's agenda for the plenary session on Tuesday. Cooler heads eventually prevailed, and Zubiri says everything is now good between him and Cayetano.
We made up already, wala nang hard feelings. Pero alam niya kasi, they were passing something na hindi namin alam, wala sa agenda. I understood, that's when I understood that it meant a lot to him kasi tagi.
Yes.
Pero alam mo naman ako, I'm a stickler for rules. Hindi tayo pikit mata na gusto natin pasalan tayo ng pasa. Ang malamag po ako, sabi ko, mayroon naman tayong bukas. Mayroon naman tayong session bukas. Medyo nagalit siya. Hindi tayo mag-aaway kung nag-focus tayo. Yeah.